Neighbours discovered Mr. Taylieb's body early on Sunday morning, lying face down just metres from the veranda steps of his Henry Street home. A post-mortem found the self-employed painter died from massive head injuries. Police will allege that the injuries are consistent with blows from a heavy instrument, perhaps a garden spade. Late yesterday, police arrested and charged two people with murder. Christine Lee Rush, 19, of Mayfield, and 23-year-old Anthony John Hall were transported separately to Newcastle Courthouse to appear before Magistrate Kel Clark. Both were refused bail and will appear in Newcastle Court on December 22nd.
There are 19 members of the Madawi Christian Volunteers. They've been a group for 6 months and range in age between 14 and 43. They share three houses around Madawi and pool their incomes, living off $35 a week each. Only one member of the group has a paid full-time job, yet the group finances and distributes its own fortnightly newspaper and does voluntary community work such as mowing lawns. However, the Department of Social Security states if a person's time is taken up with activities that preclude their looking for paid work, that person isn't eligible for unemployment benefits. Group founder Dave McKay says he and the other group members apply for jobs, but place being useful above finding full-time paid employment.
The department in Mayfield, or perhaps the department as a whole, it's not really clear yet, seems to be bothered by the fact that they're staying busy, that they're productive, that they're enthusiastic. They seem to want to maintain the image of dole bludgers, that is, worthless individuals who have nothing to do with their lives and sit around and watch TV and get drunk all day.
What makes you think they think that?
Because they have specifically said to us that the group is under a special investigation on the basis of the fact that they're doing volunteer work. And they've made visits out here.
He says the group receives donations for its voluntary work, but that's declared as income.
You said before there wasn't much work around in the Madawi area, and yet you and your wife specifically came to Madawi to establish the group in a nice quiet area. Doesn't that conflict?
No, we came here as far as looking for the climate, looking for cheap accommodation. When we arrived in this area, this is what was advertised, so we took it.
So perhaps mightn't it be better to set the group up in an area where there was more work available, perhaps to make more money for the group?
If somebody would like to offer us some accommodation somewhere else, then we'll accept it.
Why did you set the group up?
I'm not sure what you mean by that.
Why did you form the group in Madawi?
We're trying to share our Christian faith. We're trying to help people. We're trying to help the people in the group as well as helping the community as a whole. And we feel that in what we're doing, we're providing an experience, learning skills for the people in the group, and we're also providing services to the community.
Do you think the group could be seen as a religious cult?
What is a cult? The fact that we have faith in God and we're sharing our faith, I don't think makes us a cult. If so, then every denomination in Australia is one.
Meanwhile, it's not Mr. McKay's first clash with the authorities. In May 1984, he and some Christian associates were involved in this incident at the Reserve Bank. As a result, he was convicted of being knowingly concerned with damage to Commonwealth notes.
With the Christmas season here, many families are gearing up for their annual holiday. But the message from police is that burglars don't take holidays. They just keep on doing what they're best at, breaking in. However, there are a number of precautions which people can take to ensure that their house is not the easy pick of the street. According to police, make your house look lived in by not closing over curtains and get a neighbour to bring in your mail and cancel all newspapers.
Well, it's a good idea if you're going away for a prolonged period to get people to mow your lawns if you've got good neighbours. Get someone at least to clear your letterbox out. With the appearance of this, what they call junk mail, it is again an indicator for people that the house is unoccupied. If you've got a neighbour that has two cars, get them to park one in your driveway. Have someone in to open and shut the curtains through the day. A radio or light going at night's also a good idea. They're just common sense steps to give the outward appearance that someone's there.
Police are also warning people to be careful with their money while doing Christmas shopping.
We do tend to carry large sums of money with us. Now, thieves are aware of this practice, and ladies particularly should take care with their handbags and hold them to the front of their body, pressed in under their arm. Men with their wallets should be beware of them, having them in the back pocket, put them into a coat pocket. There's also leaving them in shopping trolleys while they're picking up articles off a shelf, or mothers dealing with their children, for whatever reason, in the supermarket. The purse is on top, it's an open invitation for them to come along.
The Bullockies drove six beasts down Clarence Town's main street. After 78 days on the road, the wagon was right on schedule. The event is a tribute to Australia's early pioneers who opened up the country through sheer determination and hard work. For the children of Clarence Town Primary School, it was a chance to sample a piece of colonial Australian history. They clambered onto the traditional tabletop wagon built especially for the dry, dusty journey. The Bullock Drive has not been without hardship.
We had problems in the first keeping the shoes on. We've got that all ironed out, and then we had the 8 bullock style antenna poisoning. We put them in a paddock just for one night, and they had one feed of it, and it killed 8.
So you're down to 6?
Yeah, down to 6, but we can bring that up to, with the support I'm getting now, I could bring it up to 103 days if I had to.
What? But all the Bullockies say they'd do it again. They still have another 40 days to go before they'll reach Parramatta for the Australia Day celebration.
The accident happened at this service station shortly after midday, the only evidence of the tragedy, an extensively damaged petrol bowser. Police say a 69-year-old man was crushed between two cars which were refuelling at the time. It's believed the victim was stooped over the vehicle when he was pinned between the rear tow ball and the front fender, suffering severe internal injuries. He was pronounced dead on arrival at Newcastle Base Hospital. A young woman, also transported by ambulance officers, was treated for shock. The Police Accident Investigation Squad is continuing inquiries.
It was bedlam in the city today as people jostled to get into town and do their last-minute Christmas shopping. Shops did a roaring trade. It's a time when there are very few window shoppers, just people keen to buy. But no one was busier than Santa. He was overrun with children who queued patiently to ensure that their orders were well and truly placed before he packs his sleigh. This year, shoppers are opting for quality presents for adults rather than fads. Items such as French perfume and men's toiletries are selling well. But for children, the array is dazzling. Last year's Transformers are passé. For boys, they've given way to the G.I. Joe range. There are good guys and bad guys and Rambo, and all with movable joints. But if that's not enough, how about something from the Ghostbusters range? These monsters come with goop and simply ooze personality. And in the soft toy range, Alf has been a front runner and has proved so popular that many shops have sold out. While Cabbage Patch Kids are still selling, albeit at a less frenetic pace. And then there's Barbie. She seems to have been around forever.
But it appears as if Barbie might be in peril. Mattel opted for a Barbie revival this year and brought out these dolls, Barbie and the Rockers. Unfortunately, according to David Jones' staff, they sold well initially, but then slumped.
But according to the president of the Retail Traders Association, trading in the lead-up to Christmas was a bit disappointing.
The people were very, very worried early in December, but it has come good again.
This
So this is Christmas.
Tis the night before Christmas when Santa's on his way, so we search to find the meaning of this very special day.
And you won't just be gone.
Oh, it means lots of family, lots of remembrance.
So this is Christmas.
Yes, yeah, sometimes.
Bringing presents and
I'm hoping Santa's going to touch you.
The near and the dear
ones.
For me, Christmas is a time where we can all share the love which draws together family and friends, and look to the faith in the world and one another that can build a good for the year coming year, hope and inspiration.
What about Santa Claus? Do you think he's got as much impact as he used to have?
Yes.
Well, what does Christmas mean for you nowadays?
Well, it means a lot. Be alive. Means a lot.
It's really terrific.
It's a great festival, and there's no reason why we shouldn't be able to celebrate the value of the
champion and local hero Chris Watson will be putting his state speedway title on the line. The biggest threat to Watson will come from another local, Stephen Davies, who lost the championship to Watson in a thrilling final. Davies has spent a season overseas and has come back a very polished performer who should be hard to toss. Other top riders, all capable of causing upset, include Todd Wilshire, Craig Boyce and Tony Primer. The program will also feature super sedans, sidecars, Formula 500s and stock cars.
Chris Watson from Cessnock, and look at Brian Nixon.